The following portion of Daytime Blue Ridge is sponsored by...
Our area just got a whole lot of rain in a short amount of time, which has affected many homes across our region.
Yeah, if you discovered water in your basement or crawl space, you need to act fast. Joining us now to talk more about how to remove water safely and permanently, we have the manager from Crawl Space Care, Derek Heath. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us back.
Yeah, absolutely. So tell people about Crawl Space Care if they're not familiar.
Crawl Space Care is kind of a sister company to Bugman Exterminating. We've went more into the routes of encapsulating. We waterproof dehumidifiers, basically any service you may need in your crawl space, and we can dry out basements as well. We don't do basement waterproofing, but we do and install dehumidifiers in those areas.
Okay. So as we've been saying, there was a lot of rain. So yes. How is this affecting crawl spaces, and how will it affect crawl spaces?
Well, the initial part of it is just the actual water itself. The foundation may leak, or it could be pressure from the water table just coming up so high. But then that absorbs into the wood, into the air, and just causes a lot of trouble with fungus. Could be, you know, swelling of wood and causing floors to buckle and things like that. Really, after an event like this is the best time to have your crawl space checked out to see if you're prone to any of those issues.
Yeah, we were just looking at some pictures of what it looks like when there's water in your crawl space. Yeah. Can that affect the interior of your home too?
Absolutely. It can damage the indoor air quality that you have. It really brings that down, whether it's fungal spores, you know, that type of thing. It's just bad for the house. The insulation under the house can get saturated, and once that happens, it has no R value, so you're losing money on heating and air as well.
Yeah. So what are the options to fix your crawl space or home interior?
It's going to vary on what you actually have going on. You may need, as far as full-on waterproofing encapsulation if you had a severe problem, or it could be that you just need a dehumidifier down there to dry it out. Mm-hmm. Every home should have a good quality vapor barrier under it if it has a crawl space. So, you know, it's a lot of different options. It's going to depend on what you actually need at your house.
And do you all come and, like, if you were to ask me, I would have no idea what I needed. Right. So do you all come and do like a home visit?
Yes, we do. We offer free inspections. So right now, after an event like this, like I say, this is the time to get it checked out. You can see what's actually going on, and our inspections are free. Our guys know what they're doing. They know what to look for, and can offer pictures and videos if you don't want to go into those nasty spaces like you've seen in the pictures.
Yeah, the pictures that we were looking at with the white covering, what is that and how is that done?
That's what I was calling is the actual vapor barrier. What that is to basically to seal that moisture that comes out of the soil from coming up into the air, which absorbs into the wood, insulation. It can cause condensation on your HVAC ducts and things like that, so which all lead to problems.
Yeah.
But you recommend just a fully closed crawl space.
You know, if you're in the position where you can, that's your best option for your home. In the long run, it's going to be much better. Added value to the home. Better air quality inside the house, no musty odors. But one of the biggest things is a full encapsulation or closed crawl, which is what we install, can lead to about an 18% energy savings on an annual basis.
Wow. All right. So if people want more information, they can contact you at crawlspacecareva.com or give you a call 491-0141.